our school's general requirements give all of our students a broad background in a variety of academic disciplines. We feel that as journalists, you need to have exposure to all different types of subject matter, from courses in the social sciences, the humanities, natural sciences, and mathematics, so that you have a rich pool of information from which to draw when you're on the job. The good news about the way we have structured our general requirements is they also align very closely with the university's Tier 2 requirements. We will talk about the tiers in a separate video in more detail, but many of the courses that you'll take to fulfill our school's general requirements will also help you meet the university Tier 2 requirements. If you have taken AP courses during high school and earned a score of 3 or higher, or if you have taken some of the post-secondary education courses at one of your local institutions of higher education in Ohio, many of those credits will transfer to Ohio University and help you fulfill your general requirements. We ask you to take some specific courses as part of your general requirements, but very often, most times, we give you the ability to select any course from a given major. And if you notice, when you look down at the check sheet, the number of blocks that are next to the label of the discipline actually corresponds to the number of courses that you have to take to fulfill that particular requirement. So if you'll notice, there's a single block in front of the political science requirement. We don't specify any particular course, so what that means is that you can take any one of the numerous political science courses offered by the political science department, and that will fulfill that requirement. Similarly, if you look at the history requirement, we have two blocks there, so we're asking you to take any two history courses that Ohio University offers. Now, one question that I often get from my advisees is they will find a course that has some aspect of history involved in it that's taught by a department other than the history department. For example, one very popular course is the history of rock and roll that's taught in the music department. While that is a wonderful course, and we would encourage you to take it as a general elective that would help you get to your 192 quarter hours for graduation, or your 120 semester hours for graduation, we are asking you specifically to take these history courses from within the history department. There are some general requirements that you have to take a specific course. For example, Philosophy 120 is a logic course that we require of all journalism majors. So you'll notice on the check sheet, the actual course number 120 is clearly designated. There are a few courses that we don't specify specifically on the check sheet, but most of our students end up taking them because in whatever that academic discipline is, that course is a prereq very often for the higher level courses. So for example, we require one psychology course. When you look on the check sheet, we don't specify a particular number for that course, but most of our students end up taking the Psychology 101 introductory course because in the psychology curriculum, that's usually a prereq for most of the other upper level courses. Similarly, to fulfill our economics requirement, we require two courses. Most of our students take Economics 103 and Economics 104 because those are the foundational courses for the upper level coursework. Economics 103 is microeconomics, and Economics 104 is macroeconomics. You can take those courses in either order, but I have found over the years that it's a good idea to complete them in succession so that you stay in sort of economics mode and get those courses out of the way one after another. We also have a foreign language requirement. We are encouraging you incoming freshmen to go ahead and fulfill your foreign language requirement either your freshman year or your sophomore year, which means you'll be doing it under the quarter system. So you must take three courses in under the quarter system to fulfill your foreign language requirement. You can either take a foreign language or you can also take sign language. If you test into the beginning level of the foreign language, and I just mentioned the test, during Bobcat student orientation, all of you will be asked to take a foreign language placement exam so that we know at what level you should begin taking your foreign language coursework. If you test into the beginning level, you would start at the 111 course number. The foreign language courses typically go 111, 112, 113. Then the upper level courses similarly are 211, 212, and 213. However, some of you may have enough foreign language background in high school that you do fairly well on the placement exam and you get into that 200 intermediate level. However, it might have been a couple of years since you have taken a foreign language, or perhaps you're just not as confident in your foreign language skills. If you placed into that intermediate level and you need a refresher course, you are eligible to take the 199 course, which is a review course to help you prepare for that upper level. However, you still need to take 3 full quarters of your foreign language to fulfill our requirement. You'll also notice that towards the end of our list of general requirements, there are 2 that have the arts and sciences designation in front of them. The first is actually very specific. We ask you to take 1 arts and sciences course that fulfills a cross-cultural perspectives point of view. This corresponds to the university's Tier 2 requirement for cross-cultural perspectives, but we are asking you, instead of picking from the broad selection of cross-cultural perspectives courses that will be listed on your DARS under the Tier 2 requirement, that would be from departments all across the university. For journalism, we're asking you to select from a subset of those Tier 2 courses that come specifically from the College of Arts and Sciences. We are also asking you to take 1 additional elective course from any major within the College of Arts and Sciences. If you're not sure which majors actually fall under the Arts and Sciences distinction, you can go into your course catalog and look up Arts and Sciences and see all of the many majors listed, things like the foreign languages, things like humanities courses, including English courses and history courses. Also, social sciences courses like economics are all part of arts and sciences. You can also look on the university website. If you go under academics and you click on the Arts and Sciences College, you can see all of the many majors that are offered in arts and sciences. You might ask yourself, why so many specific arts and sciences courses? Well, it's because we are an accredited institution of journalism. And in order to maintain our accreditation, we have to have a certain number of liberal arts courses for our students. Accreditation is something that's very special for schools of journalism around the country. It is bestowed upon us by a team of reviewers who come every 6 years. That team is made up of not only journalism educators from some of our peer universities, but also professional journalists who are working in public relations and in broadcasting and all of the other forms of media that we teach here. Basically, they come and they review our program and they make sure that we're giving you exactly what you need to succeed in our field. On the check sheet, you'll notice that there are 3 requirements that actually give you a choice of 2 different majors in which you can take a course to fulfill the requirement. The first you'll notice is either a sociology course or an anthropology course. Again, it's up to you to decide which of those 2 disciplines you're most interested in, and you can choose a course in either. I mentioned that you have to take Philosophy 120, which is a logic course. In addition to that, we ask you to take either a second philosophy course, any course offered in the major, or we give you the option of taking a course in the Classics and World Religion department. Finally, lower down on the list of requirements, you'll note that you can take a course in either the African American Studies department or in the Women and Gender Studies department. It's up to you. One note about the Women and Gender Studies course that you might choose. Women and Gender Studies offers a certificate program, and so they list a number of courses from a variety of disciplines that they would like their certificate students to take. We are asking you to pick a course from their catalog specifically, so from the Women and Gender Studies major that has the WGS distinction.